back at it again at the Gunnison Montrose Regional Airport. Even though it's now an international airport, and I'm still yet to change the sign. International flights are coming in, including a bunch more regional routes. Find out next in this episode of Airport Update. For the first aircraft of the update, we have this Boeing 757-200 freighter of DHL Express. This is operated by Air Transport International. This aircraft has just recently been based out of the airport for the 2020 cargo peak season. And this aircraft has been operating short routes between cities in Texas and up and down the west coast of the United States. This aircraft is actually just now arriving in on runway 25 after a flight from Laredo, Texas.
Now, moving on to the terminal. The first aircraft we have is the normal mining charter from Extra Airways. This is a leased 737-800 from SmartWings. Yeah, SmartWings.com. This aircraft just arrived in from Denver Centennial Airport, and it will be heading out to Bozeman, Montana in a matter of hours. Sliding on over to the gate right next door to the Extra Airway 737, we have a new aircraft and new airline for the airport. Recently, the airport has welcomed the arrival of Allegiant Air. They fly all days of the week to Austin, Texas, Las Vegas, Nevada, San Diego, California, and Nashville, Tennessee. So it's a total of 4 round-trip flights a day to those destinations. And the airline is expected to stay at the airport through the ski season and farther after that, as long as the flights are successful. And the airline has also expressed interest in expanding to possibly set up a focus city at GMR, which would be very interesting considering the year we've been having, but would also be very cool to see. It is winter in Colorado, so it's going to be a whole lot more common to see aircraft being de-iced at the airport. Here we have a Delta Connection CRJ-200 operated by SkyWest. This aircraft was just pushed out of the stand and is currently being de-iced before a flight out to Salt Lake City. I told you what routes Allegiant flew out of the airport, but I didn't tell you which one this was flying today. This Allegiant A320 arrived in from San Diego about an hour ago and currently is being boarded, final bags loaded before a flight off to Nashville. Moving on over to the gate. The one single gate at GMR is now occupied by Delta Airlines. They purchased the gate from American as soon as they decided that they were going to expand operations out of GMR. And American reluctantly sold the gate to Delta, so Delta now occupies that gate, this stand here, and shares that stand with Allegiant Air. But Delta has also announced expansions out of the airport. They will now be flying 7 days a week to Cincinnati CVG, Atlanta ATL, Seattle, Los Angeles LAX, Minneapolis St. Paul, and New York JFK. All these flights and the schedules will be separate and will be determined depending on the weekday. But yep, the 737-900 arrived in on the seasonal route from New York JFK about 30 minutes ago, and the aircraft was not expected to have to leave so shortly. In fact, it's not expected to depart for another hour. However, there is an issue with the windshield wipers of the aircraft, so that departure is expected to be delayed. However, that might cause problems, as you may see in a minute. And for the final aircraft over by the terminal area, we have this McDonnell Douglas MD-88 of all American Air Charters, or AAA Charters. This aircraft arrived in from the shuttle route yesterday from Denver Centennial Airport and is just taking a maintenance break before it will be heading back out into the skies on other charter operations. Condor Airlines has recently opened up shop at the airport, flying once a week on Fridays, direct to and from Frankfurt, Germany. This Boeing 767-300 is the same aircraft that they will be flying through the entire peak season to and from Montrose Gunnison Regional Airport, or the other way around. And yeah, this aircraft actually requires the gate, which the Delta 737 is currently occupying, which may cause a delay in this aircraft's arrival into the gate until they can either get the Delta aircraft pushed back and pulled into another stand, or they figure out some other solution. I didn't think of the word there. So yeah, for now, this aircraft, like I said, just arrived in from Frankfurt, Germany, and will be departing back to Frankfurt, Germany in about 5 hours. Moving over to the signature FBO ramp, we do have some aircraft that are other than the normal Cessnas today, such as this private Douglas DC-3. This aircraft arrived in from the Bennett Municipal Airport, and this will be departing out to Rifle, Colorado later tonight. As the normal update goes, not much happening at the Colorado fire area. Fire season is over for now, thankfully, and right now the main operations out of here are just rescuing skiers at the nearby resorts with rescue helicopters and any other medevac that may be needed. Over at the Colorado State Trooper Hangar, they do have their two aircraft out because it's a somewhat nice but chilly day in the mountains. So yeah, the troopers just decided to pull out their aircraft and get some fresh air today. And moving on to Groom's Air National Guard Base, the aircraft have returned home from overseas. So happy to report all airmen returned home safely from the Pacific. However, the F-35s from the 205th Fighter Wing are remaining in the Pacific for now. However, that is not an issue. They are just actually in the process of being switched over to a combat-specific unit rather than just being Air National Guard units. Now moving over to the cargo area. First aircraft, we have a Boeing 757-200 of UPS. This aircraft arrived in from Louisville, and for a quick little change-up for once, this aircraft will be departing to the Boeing Payne Field in Seattle, Washington, rather than SDF or Ontario. This is because a Boeing 757 actually broke down in Seattle, and this is the nearest aircraft that they could put that cargo on, and so yeah, they need to send this up to Seattle to replace that broken down 757. At the always awesome former American Airlines Boeing 767-300, now operated by Air Transport International for Amazon Prime Air. This aircraft is currently being loaded for a flight off to Wilmington, Ohio. And lastly, for the final aircraft of the airport update, we had this blank Boeing 767-300 freighter of Amazon Prime Air. This aircraft arrived in from Miami, Florida, and this will be departing out to Portland PDX in approximately an hour. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, I hope you enjoyed all the new aircraft in the update. Yeah, so peak season for cargo and ski season is on in full swing. I hope by the next airport update, I will have even more aircraft to show off to you guys. But for now, this should do it. Hope you all have a great rest of your days. Good evening, good night, good morning, whenever you're watching this. And I will see you all in the next video. Goodbye.